In the 19th century, Charles-Pierre Tremaux was thinking about mazes. His ideas were an early version of what, 100 years later, became known as depth-first search. That algorithm is the basis of problem-solving in Prolog. Tremaux's approach had just four rules, and one involved backtracking, retracing a path already followed. We can explore with a simple program. It's an expansion of one we've seen before. Let's add a number to each clause to follow what Prolog does for this query. Prolog always searches top-down, and we can visualize the process with nodes like this. The contents show what Prolog has to prove. Prolog does matching against each program clause, and here we have the same predicate name and the same number of arguments, but recursively checking the arguments fails. Prolog continues the search to clause 2. The predicate name and arity are the same, but again, the arguments don't match. The search continues to clause 3. The predicate name and arity are the same, and the arguments all match too. So clause 3 lets Prolog succeed. This empty node means there's nothing left to prove, and the original question is true. Instead of drawing all the failed matches, this tree is more compact. Queries can have variables. Clause 1 matches again with the byproduct of variable bindings. Those instantiations are offered by Prolog to the user. Pressing return means the search is done, but if the user asks for other solutions, Prolog revisits its choice of clause 1. There are other lines in the program that haven't been checked, so Prolog can continue its search. It finds another match that produces different variable bindings, so can suggest a new solution to the user. If the user accepts these, the search is done. That loop up to redo a choice already tried is a backtrack. Let's also try a query that uses a rule. For rules, matching is carried out on the head, and clause 6 is the first success. We get variable bindings for X and Z, and with those bindings, the rule instantiates like this. We have a new goal to prove. Prolog tries, but finds no matches. So it revisits the choice of clause 6. Another backtrack. Matching succeeds next on the head of clause 7, with variable bindings that instantiate the rule like this. Again, we have new goals to prove, and Prolog tries them one at a time in order. A new top-down search for this goal matches clause 3. That satisfies the goal and instantiates Y. Starting again for the one remaining goal, succeeds with a match on the head of clause 6. And to prove the instantiated right-hand side, a final search, again from the top, finds a match in clause 4. With no goals left to prove, we've succeeded.